In this video, we want to cover how to set up email and text alerts within Track and Trade. I also want to make a note here that this feature is exactly the same whether we're using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I'm using the futures version for this demonstration. By simply right-clicking on the chart, you'll get a right-click menu that you'll notice down here has a charts alert setting. If you go ahead and click that, if you have the preferences tab selected, you'll notice that we end up with a email text alert window setting. So the first thing we want to do is we want to come in here and we say use email text alerts. So we turn that on. The first thing we get, if we have not set this up, is a warning window that says you will need to set up your alert email setup first. This is done under the view menu alert email setup. So if you say OK, it automatically pulls up the settings window. Now I'm going to go ahead and close this. You can find that same window over here under view, and it's right here, alert email setup. So you get the same window. So first we have to put this in here, and you put my name, and then you send the send email alert to who you want the email alert to, which would be, let's just say this is going to be let's say me@gmail.com, and the reply address is going to be the same, me@gmail.com. And then if we come down here and we select Gmail, it's going to automatically select all of our settings for us for the server. Now if you press the drop down and your server is not listed, you can press other, and then you can go in and get your SMTP information from your email provider and fill it in here. But let's go in here, and since ours is just in here as a Gmail account, we're going to go Gmail, and it automatically sets this up for us automatically. Now it says server requires authentication, so I'm going to put in my email username, and let's say that my username is Lan Turner, and my email password is entered here. Now we can go ahead and we can hit test, and it's going to send a test. Now of course the test failed in my case because these are not actual credentials. If you have actual credentials, it will come up and say test has completed, and it will send you an email indicating that it has the correct information. We also have an alerts log, and this is going to tell you all of the alerts that it's going to send, and you can go down and see a log of everything that's been sent to you through your alert system. We can also send account disconnect and reconnect messages if you would like. That's a choice here. Sometimes you'll lose connection to the internet for one reason or another. Your internet provider cuts your system or something. This will send you an account disconnect and reconnect if possible, if it can get the email through. If we've lost connection completely, you may not be able to even get emails. But this is, once this is set up, we go ahead and we hit OK. Now we can come in here and we can say we want to use email text alerts, and we're going to come in here and we're going to say we want buy and sell signals. Maybe we want to have anytime an order is placed, or anytime an order is filled, or order is closed. And this is very nice when you're using the autopilot in particular, because the autopilot functions autonomously, and oftentimes you'll want it to tell you, notify you when it's doing things. So when it's placing orders, or an order is filled, or an order is closed. Once this is done, you can also add open profit and loss to the message, you can add the account balance to the message, you can get all kinds of really nice information emailed to you or text message to you. We can also come in and we can have audible notifications as well. So we can come in and we say, I want to have a target price audible only. And I can come in and I can say, send email or text when the market hits a specific price. And so you can see in here that we have this this price set in here, and we can say that, and we can set that by saying show on-screen price marker. It drops it just at the 50% level, then you can drag that with the handle, you can drag it up and down, and then this is your marker. Okay, so you can see exactly where, when the market hits this particular price, you can see it updates the price here by just moving this line to a new level. So once the market hits this particular level, or this white line, which is 5.5200, then the software or Track and Trade is going to email you and text you this information. And of course, you can come in here and change the color of the line if you would like. You can change the price, the trigger color as well. You can also have a second trigger price. We can come in here, do the same thing, show another line. And so now we have a second line. This one is red. So once the market hits this price level on a retracement, then it'll send me this information once again.